First question I wanted to ask, new numbers, we're over 1 million people, workers in Michigan that have now filed for unemployment. And we've been having consistent problems with the website to file for unemployment benefits. It kind of spiked a couple of days ago. Is this problem solved, or are there other things that need to be adjusted with it?
So we've had almost a 5,000% increase in our unemployment applications. That's massive. And even though we've quadrupled the number of employees at the agency, we know that we've got a lot of work to meet everyone's need, and they're working incredibly hard. I'll say, just as a point of perspective, not as an excuse, but that, you know, if you just watch a little bit of the nightly news, you know that this is a problem in every state in the nation, frankly, and in states as big as ours, especially. But the fact of the matter is, we're going to get to every single person that is eligible for employment benefits. We are going to make sure that they get their checks. We've already met the needs of over 600,000 people in our state. We've got more work to do, to be sure, but we are making progress, and people in Michigan are getting a better benefit now because of some of the actions that we took to lengthen the amount of time for which you're qualified and to draw down that $600 additional dollars from the federal government. So we are well in process, but we've got work to do. And I just ask that people be patient, that they go online, see when their name is up for in the queue. We've divided the alphabet in half, and so there are certain days where it's going to be easier to navigate the system. And we ask that people just be persistent and go online and check it out.
How long is the unemployment fund going to last?
Well, we feel good about the amount of money that is available and where we are at now. Obviously, we're watching very closely, and we've just got to make sure that if there is a need to supplement, that we've got, you know, the will to do it. And I can tell you the will is there on my part. So we're going to meet the needs of our people.
Detroit's mayor, Grand Rapids mayor, they are starting to talk about, and as well, I saw the governor in Minnesota, they're starting to talk about budget cuts, that they are going to have to cut services in order to make budget for their next fiscal year. Is this something you've started thinking about, what cuts or changes you're going to make up for the loss of all this revenue?
Yeah, I mean, of course, we know that this has been a huge economic strain for individuals, for business owners, and for the state too. We know that we are going to have to make some tough decisions. We've been looking at it very closely. I applaud leaders who are being honest about that it's not going to be easy. It's going to be painful. But at the end of the day, we don't have the ability like Washington, D.C. does to run deficits. We have to have balanced budgets. And so we're going to be very responsible. I can tell you, already have taken actions to slow spending in state government, to stop hiring in state government, to analyze where we might be able to tighten our belts, and that's something that's underway as well.
Okay. You have a Midwest or a Great Lakes coalition of governors that you're now joining to talk about reopening government. Do you have any kind of a timeline yet, or what kind of metrics you want to see before this can begin?
Well, I think every scientist, epidemiologist, and healthcare professional would tell you that we have to really be paying attention to the science and to how what is happening with regard to testing and tracing, how many people are hospitalized, our hospital's ability to meet needs of patients beyond COVID-19. You know, as we've been in this posture, there are oncology patients that have not gotten surgeries because everyone is worried about the spread of COVID-19. And we have to be able to get back to doing some of those things and reengaging our economy. But it's not going to happen overnight. It's not going to be one day where it's all of a sudden just like life was of March 9th before our first two cases were detected here. We have to be really thoughtful about what sectors of our economy and what regions of our state ramp up first. And so it will come in waves. It'll be made decisions based on when is it safe? How do we have a plan to keep our employees safe as well as customers of those businesses safe as well? And so you'll learn more about the thought process and what that looks like as we get into next week.
Okay. I'd be remiss if I didn't ask this, and it is a little off topic, but yesterday Elizabeth Warren was asked if she would accept a vice presidential nomination or running mate spot with Vice President Biden on the Democratic ticket. She answered in one word, yes. Your name, as I'm sure you know, has been talked about a lot as a potential running mate. If the Vice President Joe Biden asked you to be his running mate, would you say yes?
You know, here's what I told everyone. I appreciate the question and I applaud your effort to try to get something out of me that others can't. But the fact of the matter is, I've got my hands full with COVID-19. This is a crisis unlike we've seen in 100 years in this country. This is something that is all hands on deck and it takes every ounce of energy. I'm not thinking about politics right now. I'm thinking about how do we save lives and start to reengage our economy safely. And that's all I've got energy for.
Yeah, I understand. I got to ask or I get in trouble. Yeah, I'm sure you know how it works. Yeah.
It was a nice try.
Well, I appreciate it. Last question, I'll let you go. I know you probably got more of these. The number of COVID-19 cases that are spiking in these tightly knit groups like senior care facilities and prisons, is there anything in specific being done at the state level to try and address this?
Yeah, we've taken great strides, especially with regard to our population that's incarcerated, to make sure that we are paroling people who are eligible for parole, and we're doing it very quickly. We're working 7 days a week on that, frankly, because the fewer people that are in these close quarters, the better we will be able to mitigate the spread. And I think we've made some good strides, and I know other states are asking us how we're doing it. So despite that, of course, we do have the presence of COVID-19. And I don't mean to downplay that. That's my dog barking. Sorry. With regard to our nursing homes, the DHHS is working very closely with Lara. We are having, I issued an executive order yesterday about protections for employees so that they stay home when they are sick and don't get fired, so that they don't bring COVID into facilities like this. So we're working on a number of fronts to protect people in those living facilities.